2 weeks ago, I posted a world history of Super Mario Bros. World records. This video talked exclusively about the any percent category, beating it in under 5 minutes. The maximum is 4 minutes 54 seconds. But what if I told you something else? The standard way to beat this is 8 levels. But what if I told you you could beat this game warpless? Getting all 100%, not even to use any warps at all. This includes not being able to skip any worlds. You have to beat every level one by one. In 2005, a person called Andrew G cleared Mario Bros. The original in 21 minutes, 18 seconds. To explain, as this video is from over 17 years ago, 18 years ago to be exact, speedrunning wasn't really popular at the time. It was properly recorded on VHS the same year YouTube existed, and his run was flawless. Not only did he not use amazing movement, but he was pretty well throughout the stage, and I kind of agree that he was really amazing. At this time, this run was really primitive, and no one was really challenging his run up until this point, especially in World 4-4. And I think he did a really good job at it. He was able to close in under 22 minutes. People were waiting for people to downtime that record into the next limit. And for 2 years, for half a year, people were challenging it until Andrew G did it again. The next SMB warpless world record wouldn't be broken until 2007, where Andrew G did it again, but with the Super Mario Bros. / Duck Hunt combo, as he was able to power through this level. Not exactly did I even explain this, but he powered through this better than he last did it. Comparing, it had better quality, as he went faster, and not to be exact, he just broke the record in just under 2 minutes less. To how could he beat it in just getting all 100%? To explain this, he even pulled off a lot of strats to even beat Bowser's 8 times in a row. This holds up to date to what we'll see later on. One year later, Andrew G returned to Mario Bros. Speedrunning, downing the record by just 17 seconds, downing at 19 minutes 40 seconds, a former world record. It will have to say that this record would have held out today, and people would have really challenged Andrew G to continue to do well. Over the past few months of discovering how many strats in order to beat Mario Bros. Faster, there will come many more parts where we will look at this. But at the moment, his run looked pretty fabulous. He never really stopped running, and people would have never have challenged him. And besides, his runs are being recorded on Speedrunner's Archive. These are really those where the runs are. So after the team, he continued to put in the pressure into how he'll do his runs. Speedrunners weren't sure what Andrew G was doing with his life, but apparently his speedrunning record lasted a while. But not exactly though. We don't really need to talk about it right now, because apparently a while then, people then started to not break the world record. But Andrew G's run inspired many people back in the younger days of speedrunning, back in the retro days of speedrunning, that it could be possible to beat a game in under 20 minutes. apparently he was the primest person back in the old days. But not exactly though. His record would have stand below his personal best. For 4 years, the world record wasn't tackled yet until Cosmic in 2012. This one was released over 10 years ago. Simply put, he really decided to move really quickly and use as many strats as possible to get to the end, warpless. Now this is used in a really different perspective of mine, as this run was recorded a long time ago. I could analyze how his movement was really good and how he was able to keep up his momentum whilst running, and it also holds up to what we know today. But despite that, his run was also really fantasy. This other person called Haratabu made a video where he downed the record by just 1 second, but apparently there's no video proof. So instead we'll fast forward to another one. Andrew G took down the record to all the way to just 19 minutes 20 seconds, but his run was a lot more primitive, as exactly. He didn't always remain as small Mario most of the time, he switched to Fire Mario at some points. This is because some enemies have blocked some areas, and he uses Fire Flowers in quick pace so he can get rid of the enemies fast. This is used because usually with small Mario, you'll get hit once, but Fire Mario just got rid of the enemies quickly. That's how he did it. And really, I think his previous runs were pretty solid, but eventually in his runs, he started off really strong. And the world record wasn't really just far from being broken, as he would go on to break world records many times. Over the past many months of grinding, he kept grinding the time down by just 1 second every time. But apparently there is another person who kept downing time the record, which we're gonna get to. But Andrew G's run returned, and it feels like his speedrunning run was really fast paced. So, honestly, he did really good. With many new months of no new strats being found out, people continue to grind and see if Andrew G's record can be broken.
Saradox posted a 19 minutes 10 seconds beating the game Warpless. He used many different strats in order to beat the game. The most frequent being in World 1-2, where he used Go Super Mushroom and bounced even higher.
Right off the bat, obviously, two scalp dishes, and everyone thinks that this run could be brilliant, amazing. But simply, Saradox used very good different techniques during the modern world of Mario speedruns. But how he did it is far more superior as it was. To under the fact that another speedrunner would rise to the top. Someone would go on to break another record by just 6 seconds by Warpless.
Darbian posted a run in 2016, beating the game in 19 minutes 4 seconds. How this run defies the odds is that he used many different elements and strats used in previous runs and previous years. Not only did Darbyan perform really well, but he did extreme amazing movement and was able to clear every single stage. Not only was he that fast, he continued to push on in the run, beating through Bowser fights with ease. Not only that, this is why he got the record back, was because he had stepped up for the first time and to beat it. How do you think that someone could beat this game? Like, bet if you're that stupid, you would have spent the rest of your life down that. But Darbyan's run expected another person to do it again. Not only was Cosmic's run just 2 seconds below Darbyan, but his movement was also the same and as incredible ways as he did it. Previously, he had done it before, despite his other runs where he beats it in just the record of time, but Cosmic made sure that his movement never stopped, as people weren't really able to challenge. The next one is JT Ace rocking in at 18 minutes 59 seconds, just 3 seconds less, and just under 19 minutes. And that's all I have to cover for today. I don't really want to do any more, but I have to say GT Ace's run was pretty flawless. But yeah, he was really moving through the whole time, and I don't think he was doing that bad of a job. He rocked in between the 19 minute mark. It was under 19 minutes, and I'm proud of him for that. Make sure to like and subscribe and leave a comment below.